Hello students, I welcome you all to the e-learning sessions of LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Myself Hardik Shah and I am here to share my knowledge with you all about the subject of automobile engines. Okay, so we have already started a new session on the new chapter on a supercharging, turbocharging and scavenging, and our today's topic in this video is methods of supercharging and turbocharging. Fine, so let's start our video. First, let's see the methods of supercharging. Basically, there are 5 methods for supercharging in the IC engine. The first one is compressor driven by the engine. Okay. Second one is compressor driven by turbine. Third one is compressor driven by external source of power. Fourth one is compressor driven by engine shaft and free turbine. And fifth one is direct coupling between the engine, compressor and turbine. Okay, so let's see all this method. Let's see the first method, which is supercharging method. Okay, and that is compressor driven by engine. Okay, let's start. So as you all know that in this diagram you can also see the compressor is driven by engine with the help of gearing or belt drive. A certain engine output is used to run the compressor. So in this case, net output of the supercharged engine is greater than the gross output of naturally aspirated engine. Fine. The net output increases due to the supercharging, which is obtained by subtracting the power from the gross output, and the air cooler is actually used after the compressor to reduce the temperature of the air so that further density of the air is also increased. Fine. So that was the first method. Second method of the supercharging is compressor driven by turbine. So in this arrangement, the compressor is actually driven by the turbine, which runs with the help of exhaust gas, which is coming from the engine exhaust as shown in this figure. So in this case, engine output is not fully utilized to drive the compressor, but exhaust energy of the engine is used to the turbine, which is actually coupled with the compressor. There is no mechanical connection between the engine and supercharger. Fine. So this arrangement is also called turbocharged supercharger. Okay, that was the second method. Next method is compressor driven by external source of power. So in this arrangement, what is happening? The compressor is neither driven by engine nor it is driven by turbine. But what is happening? The compressor is actually separately driven by the external power source as shown in this figure. That means by some motor or you can say gear drive. Fine. Next method of the compression is compressor driven by the shaft and free turbine. So in this arrangement, what is happening? Power produced by the engine is utilized only to run the compressor as shown in figure. The exhaust gas coming from the engine is actually utilized to run the turbine. The power produced by turbine is used for external load, and this arrangement is also known as generator type supercharging. So that was that method. And next method is direct coupling between engine, turbine and compressor. Okay, so what is happening here? In this arrangement, the compressor, engine and turbine all are coupled together with the help of gearing as shown in figure. So in this case, what is happening? If the turbine output is not enough to run the compressor during the part load on the engine, which engine power which takes care of the remaining of the load of the compressor. So in the addition to this, extra power from the turbine can be fed to the engine. So that was the method for supercharging. Let's see methods of turbocharging. So there are 3 different methods for turbocharging. First one is constant pressure turbocharging, thereafter pulse converter turbocharging, and thereafter pulse turbocharging. These are 3 methods for turbocharging. Okay, so let's see one by one. So first one is constant pressure turbocharging. So what is happening here? The exhaust from the various cylinder discharge into the common intake manifold at high pressure condition than the atmosphere pressure. Fine. So what is happening there? The exhaust gas from all the cylinders are actually expanded in the exhaust valve, okay, of the engine in a constant pressure mode in a common manifold to deliver to the turbine. Thereafter, what is happening? From the common intake manifold, exhaust gases are supplied to the turbine where it is actually expanding, okay, to produce the mechanical work. Fine. Now what is happening in turbine? In the turbine, the blowdown energy is actually formed of the internal energy of the
exhaust gases which is actually converted to the work by means of that rotor. Okay, so the exhaust gases are maintained at the constant pressure to operate this system. So in inlet of the turbine during the whole cycle, it is actually constant. Okay, so normally this type of engine is used in many automobile engines and it is actually called the basic turbocharged engine. Fine. So what are the advantages of it? So first advantage of it is, it is actually more efficient than the pulse turbocharger that we are going to see, if the pressure ratio is actually 3 or higher than that. So it is actually more efficient than pulse one. Okay, the exhaust pipes are actually very simple for multi-cylinder, so it is easy in construction. So it is also the highly efficient turbine, so we can use it everywhere. And engine speed is actually not limitation for this generation of the pressure wave of the engine, so generation of the pressure wave of exhaust pipe. Okay, and third one, and the next one is, exhaust gases is actually supplied to the turbine at constant pressure, right, which is actually at constant temperature also. Therefore the turbine can run at high efficiency because we know what is the pressure ratio and what is the temperature. Okay, now what is the disadvantages? What is the disadvantages? Scavenging is not very efficient. Fine. In order to maintain the constant pressure, long size exhaust pipes are required. So longer pipes are required, it is actually disadvantage. It is not suitable for the two stroke engine also, right? It does not make full use of high kinetic engine, so exhaust gas which are leaving with the kinetic energy cannot be fully used. Fine. And this is due to very slow acceleration against the low increment. Okay, so that was the first one. Now second turbocharger, that is pulse turbocharging method. Okay, so in this step what is happening, a short small cross section pipe are actually used here. So they are connected with the exhaust port to the turbine. Fine. So whatever the kinetic energies are associated with them, it is actually a blow down and utilized from the exhaust towards the turbine. The exhaust pulses are actually sequential and they have minimum overlap. Fine. So the flow and the unsteadiness can help to accessible level. Okay, so we can easily use it. Then the exhaust valves are open and considerable part of the blow down energy is actually now converted into exhaust pulses. Okay, as shown in this figure. So these pulses are now fed to the turbine through that narrow exhaust pipes. Okay, so the narrow exhaust pulses having the thermal energy and it will be converted to the work in the turbine. So it is more suitable for the engines having the four or more cylinders, and it is actually commonly used in a large diesel engines. So what are the advantages of this? The space required is actually very less due to short diameter pipe, because pipes are very narrow. Okay, the more efficient than the constant pressure system, it is actually more efficient. Separate exhaust pipes are used so that various cylinders do not interface with one another. So different pipes are actually very helpful for us. Comparatively better scavenging, which is actually obtained at the low load condition due to the reduced pressure. So these are all the advantages of this system. Now what are the disadvantages that we have to see? Okay, so let's see the disadvantages. The length of the pipe and the engine speed is actually limited in these conditions. Fine. So at higher pressure, or you can say at higher pressure ratio in turbine, recovery of engine is actually very poor in this case. Okay, so what is that, what are the different disadvantages? So in this case, single or two cylinder engine turbine efficiency is very less, and the scavenging process is actually very disturbed due to the waves that have to travel very long distance because of the longer pipes. Okay, so that was the disadvantages. Now third type is pulse converter turbocharging. So what is the meaning of that? It is actually mixing of both of them. So it has good part load efficiency and also provides good scavenging. So it is combination of both of previous one. Okay, so it is a good combination of constant pressure and pulse turbocharger. By mixing of this, we can make this system. Okay, so in this pulse converter, different branches of manifolds are connected together in a special designed venturi junction. So what is happening? So they are connected before the turbine. Okay, so the pressure pulses is converted into the kinetic energy in that nozzle section of the venturi. Okay, so what is happening there? So it creates a suction effect in a exhaust line and it helps in scavenging process of the engine. Fine. So in the diffusion section, what is happening in diffusion section after venturi, the pressure is gradually increased and a high pressurized exhaust which is actually given to the turbine, so it will work better. Okay, so it gives a quick response to the engine because that venturi section. And there is also one small topic that we need to cover in this video, that is charge cooling. So what is charge cooling and what is the meaning of that? So the air charge when compressor become hot, or you can say when you compress, okay, so it becomes hot and leaves the compressor at much higher temperature, approximately 60 to 90 degrees than the ambient air temperature, where or when the air gets heated, it expands and density reduces. Therefore, the mass of air entering the cylinder becomes lesser. This reduces the oxygen for combustion, and the hot air also increases operating temperature. So the charge is actually cooled by intercooling and after cooling to overcome the complexity of the hot air. So that to maintain the density and maintain the temperature, we are actually imparting the intercooler with it, and that is called a charge cooling that we need to do. Okay, so reducing the pressure, actually increasing the pressure will also increase the temperature, and due to that the higher temperature air will actually do uncertain amounts or uncertain conditions in the combustion. So we need to decrease the temperature, and in that case what is happening, the intercooler will work and the temperature will be reduced at the same pressure condition, so we get compressed air in better condition. Fine, so that was it in this today's session. If you have any query, then you can also comment in the below section. Fine, so I will try to answer as soon as possible. And in the next videos we will cover up some of the topic of supercharger, turbocharger and scavenging. Fine, so that's it in today's video. Thank you.